All right, ladies and gentlemen. So today is the day for Ashwini. Okay. Now, before we go ahead and understand the Ashwini Nakshatra, can anyone tell me that why Surya is exalted in Aries and at what degree? Who will tell me that?
काल पुरुष कुंडली में इट्स आत्मा कारक एंड सो इट्स नेचुरली नेचुरल सिग्निफिकेटर इन दैट फर्स्ट
ओके
राशि
ओके व्हाई नेचुरल सिग्निफिकेटर
बिकॉज़ इट इज एन आत्मा कारक
ओके सो आत्मा कारक कैन बी अ नेचुरल सिग्निफिकेटर ऑफ द नाइन्थ हाउस आल्सो और द फिफ्थ हाउस आल्सो राइट नॉट नेसेसरली द फर्स्ट हाउस ऑल्दो द नेचुरल इन द नेचुरल काल पुरुष Sun is the lord of the fifth house. Why it is not exalted there? Ideally, he should be, right? He's got just one house. And he should be exalted in the Leo, in the fifth house. Okay,
sir,
what?
As,
yeah, tell me.
Sir, aisa hai ki first house self hai. Aur self kya hai? Matlab, atma jo hai, first house mein hai. Isliye ye sun ko waha uchka kar diya gaya. Aur Aries mein 10 degrees mein. सन का जो कहा जाता है वो 10 डिग्री कहा जाता है
ओके सो 10 डिग्री पे यानी कि 0 से लेके 13 डिग्री 20 मिनट तक अश्विनी है और अश्विनी नक्षत्र के अंदर ही सूर्य देवता उचके हो जाते हैं
जी
दैट इज व्हाट यू वांट टू से
जी
ग्रेट फैंटास्टिक सो यस श्रिया
सर सूरज को राजा बोला गया और राजा को गद्दी के सिंहासन पे ही राज करना अच्छा लगता है एंड फर्स्ट जो हाउस इज द रूलरशिप ऑफ द होल This thing. तो फर्स्ट हाउस में वो उच्च के हो जाते हैं
ओके ओके एनीवन एल्स हु वुड लाइक टू से दैट ओके एनीवन एल्स यस राजेश्वर
हरे कृष्णा गुरु जी
हरे कृष्णा
लाइक नेचुरली हम लोग मानेंगे कि सन इज द सोल ऑफ नेचुरल सोल कारक है और मून इज द मदर So
okay.
that's the reason whenever in the Kala Purush Kundli, sun gets exalted in the first house. Because without soul, there is no life or there is no birth.
Okay. Anyone else? Anyone else who would like to try? Yes, Meenakshi ji.
Yeah, Guruji, this is maybe our Lagna and Ascendant, our true self. Our dignity, our self-esteem, that's why that represents our sun.
Okay. Anyone else? Okay. Good one. I think you should try. You people have learned something in Jyotish Acharya, right? Anyone else? Because with nakshatra, you know, the things, the prospect will completely change. Yes, Swati.
Hare Krishna, Guruji.
Hare Krishna.
Guruji, Ashwini nakshatra is for healing. Mm-hmm. And Raja ka kaam hota hai, apni praja ki problems ko solve karna. So, ek taise healing provide karna.
Hmm. Okay. Very nice. Good. Lot of inputs are coming from a lot of people, which are very, very valid inputs. But I'll tell you the real meaning of why Sun is exalted in Aries, in the first house, in the Ashwini Nakshatra, 10 degrees, right? Okay. Why? How many of you've seen Ramayan, every serial. Someone who's not even missed a single, you know, serial. Being it in Mars, no. Okay, किसने रामायण का एक भी सीरियल मिस नहीं किया अपने जीवन में? Everyone has seen that? Almost all the serials, right? But
yes.
It is not sure that how much do you remember, right? Okay, great. वहां पर रामायण में एक अश्वमेघ यज्ञ हुआ था. ओके, सो हु विल टेल मी अबाउट व्हाट वाज एन अश्वमेघ यज्ञ? बताओ. या स्वाति, हु इज वाज रेजिंग द हैंड? ओके, यू कैन टेल. या
सर, अश्वमेघ यज्ञ में अपने घोड़े को लाइक दौड़ाया जाता है, स्टार्ट किया जाता है, तो जो जो टेरिटरी वो घोड़ा क्रॉस करके जाता है वो उस किंग के अंडर में आ जाता है. एंड द मोमेंट जहाँ वो रुक जाता है तो आई थिंक उससे वॉर करना होता है उस किंगडम से, या जो उसको जो उस घोड़े को स्टॉप करता है.
It's partially right. It's not right, actually. So, Ashwamegh Yagya, एक particular नक्षत्र में संपूर्ण किया जाता है. अश्वमेघ यज्ञ के कुछ principles हैं, कुछ protocols हैं, जो मैं आज लोगों के साथ discuss करूंगा. पहली बात, the duration of this entire ceremony of leaving a horse, right, of leaving a horse and asking all the rajyas that if they have problem with the king. Suppose, you know, I am the prime minister of India aur maine ek ghoda choda, wo Pakistan bhi gaya, वो नेपाल भी गया. अगर पाकिस्तान को कोई प्रॉब्लम नहीं है, वो उसको नमस्कार करेंगे और जाने देंगे. ओके, बट अगर उनको कोई प्रॉब्लम है, वो हमारी पावर से डरते हैं या उनको तकलीफ है हमारी पावर से, तो देन दे विल हैव टू फाइट दी राजा. ओके, कि आपको कोई तकलीफ है हमारे राज्य से और हम आपके साथ लड़ना चाहते हैं, तो आप लड़ो. But the protocol of this yagya is that the yagya has to be completed in 365 days. Okay? 365 days. Now, 365 days ke baad, jab wo puri yatra karke wapis aayega, that means you are 100% victorious. Nobody has challenged you. Nobody has any sort of challenge. Okay. And now there will be a havan, a sacrifice. And the Ashwamedh Yagya is complete, concluded, manifested. Now you see, Earth takes 365 days to move around Surya Devata, okay, 1 year. So that means Surya Devata is right now where? Aaj ki rate mein Surya Devata kahan gochar kar rahe hain? Bataiye.
Dhanu
mein.
Sagittarius.
ठीक है, Sagittarius में. और अभी क्या चल रहा है? December.
Yes.
January में यहां पर आएंगे. फेब में यहां पहुंच जाएंगे, मार्च में यहां होंगे और अप्रैल में यहां आ जाएंगे. ओके, 13th अप्रैल को क्या शुरू होता है?
बैसाखी.
बैसाखी इज नॉन एज
न्यू ईयर.
न्यू ईयर
समर.
ओके, समर, न्यू ईयर, नया साल मानते हैं हम बैसाखी को. हम आज को नया साल नहीं मानते हैं. यहां पर जब यहां पर सूर्य आते हैं 13-14 अप्रैल के आसपास, अगर हम यहां पर एक छोटा सा सॉफ्टवेयर अपना पराशरा लाइट खोलकर हम इस चीज को देखते हैं. ओके, I'm just opening the parashara and I'm gonna make Okay. April 14th. You see, I'm just going to share this, the software. You see, this is a Kundli that I've made for 14th April 2022, which is this year. And Surya has just entered Ashwini. Okay, Surya has just entered the Ashwini Nakshatra. Okay, so that means this horse has covered all the 12 zodiac signs in 1 year and now has just entered. And this horse represents what? The authority of a king. This horse represents authority of a king who has gone around the world, and has just entered the first house, Aries, after 365 days. क्योंकि धरती सूर्य के आसपास 365 दिन लगाती है पूरा एक चक्कर लगाने में, जिसको हम एक साल बोलते हैं, और जिस रोटेशन के कारण सूर्य देवता हर एक राशि में एक महीने तक रहते हैं, फॉर वन मंथ, 12 months. इसीलिए भारत में फाइनेंशियल ईयर कहाँ से शुरू होता है? फर्स्ट अप्रैल. आई मीन अमेरिका में चाहे वो जनवरी से शुरू करें, राइट? लेकिन ईस्टर्न पार्ट ऑफ द वर्ल्ड में आप फाइनेंशियल ईयर कब से कब तक मानते हो? 1 अप्रैल से 31 मार्च. आप समझ रहे हो कितने डीप लॉजिक्स हैं? वो पूरा साल उस समय खत्म हुआ मानते हैं जब सूर्य आके, सूर्य क्या है? सरकार, गवर्नमेंट, अथॉरिटी. अब सूर्य विक्टोरियस रही और अब सूर्य हिसाब लेगी, इनकम टैक्स रिटर्न भरो, नए वही खाते लगाओ, सब कुछ नया करो. नो, so technically this Surya is a fresh Surya, okay? And now suddenly the moment this Surya reaches around 10 degrees, you know, it comes out of that bracket of being a infant degree, you know, like 0, 1, 2, 3 is a very very less degree for any planet to show its power, strength. So the moment it reaches the 10 degree, the first nakshatra, right, then the exact exaltation come. Okay, so what do you mean by 10 degrees? 10 degree means 10 days. Okay, 30 degree means 30 days. That is why a zodiac is 30 degree old, okay? You understand, right? So that is why it is like this. Okay, so now here, after 365 days, the Havan happens for 10 days. On the 11th day, it is Sampurna, the Ashwamedhiyaka. And that is the time when the Supreme Raja, Suryavanshi, Raja Ram, is given the highest exaltation. Shri Ram is the Suryavanshi Raja. Shri Ram represents Surya. Okay, that is the time when Shri Ram is considered as the king of the universe. And for that, the first nakshatra at that time, you know, when Surya reaches at the exaltation space after, you know, covering all 365 days of Mother Earth, you know, actually Surya Devta is standing in between and looking at Mother Earth revolving around it and making different angles and giving the degrees to the Lagana, Lagna is the Kundli. And Lagna is also you people. Simple. That is the reason that out of 1 to 27 nakshatras, the counted started from Ashwini. Because king of all the planets was Surya. And Surya, you know, the dharti, the motion of the earth in 365 days was completed. You know, once that circle is completed, that point where that circle is completed is actually the Ashwini nakshatra. That is why they said, okay, Revati is the 12th and, you know, Ashwini is the first. That is the time when Surya Devta says that, hey, look, I am the strongest. I am the center point. You people are revolving around me. So I will become the natural significator of the first house, no matter where my home is, and will also become exalted here. I'm fully aware because, you know, I have seen all last 365 days. I have seen all the zodiac signs of Mother Earth. I have seen the entire revolver, you know, the entire revolvement of the earth. Now I know I am experienced. Right? That is the time when Surya Devata gets exalted. You know what you people should consider? When you are studying a nakshatra from today, consider every nakshatra as a karmic pocket. Okay, there are a lot of karmas are stored. But you can also call, since I have taught you about so many gunas of the nakshatras, the directions of the nakshatras, the quality of the nakshatra, the caste of the nakshatra, so many things I have taught you in first 5-7 lectures to make a very strong base. You can also consider a nakshatra like a civilization. Okay? Civilization. Civilization of what? Civilization of these traits that I have told you. There is an animal which is associated with the nakshatra. There is a bird which is associated with the nakshatra. There is a guna which is associated. There is a god which is associated. There is a deity. There is a planet which is associated with the nakshatra. There is a direction. There is a protocol. There is an element out of the five elements which is associated with the nakshatra. So that set of these things is in a pocket or in a civilization. Now, this qualities that a nakshatra has to be transmitted to you as a lagna. But then this nakshatra has no medium to transmit these qualities in you. So the planets were introduced in between, so that these planets can take these things from the nakshatra and give it to you. So there are certain planets that will be part of the civilization because when you were born, they were in a particular nakshatra. When they were in a particular nakshatra means that from the earth, from you, they were in a particular angle. They were in a particular angle. And that angle was pointing towards that nakshatra as well. Okay, so the energy. Suppose there are certain lights. There's this one light here, another light here, another light here, another light here. Now you are here and you're looking at this light. So when you're looking at this light, automatically, you know, if this is the light and this is a yellow light and this is a green light. So when you look at this light from here, right from here, this green light, because of the influence of the yellow light, will look like blue. Because they are coming in a line. You see, you know, there is a big light, uske aage choti si ek light lag gayi. Ab wo jo badi light hai, aur wo jo choti light hai, uska influence aapko dekhne ko mil raha hai. Now, aap apni drishti change karte ho, aur yahan pe dekhte ho. Yahan pe there is a yellow light, and there is a red light here. So now this yellow light is also influenced by, you know, this red light is also influenced by the yellow light, and you see a different color light, not exactly red, but, you know, this red light also has some influence on this yellow. right? So this is actually the angle that you see is the degree of a planet which is sitting in your chart. Based on the degree, you know, it is giving you the nakshatra association. Okay? You understand, right? Nakshatras are nothing but they are constellations of stars, group of stars. Okay? And they are forming an energy. They are forming a civilization. Okay? They want to settle your karma. Karmas are not with the planets. Karmas are with your nakshatras. But how will this karmas manifested through planets? And the planet which runs very, very fast. You know, Surya Devata takes 1 month. Shani takes 1 year to just cover half of the zodiac. 2.5 years to complete zodiac. And Chandra is so fast that it covers almost 1 day in one zodiac and then just run to another zodiac. So that means Chandra is a graha that is touching these pockets very oftenly. Once every month, because of its speed, because of its angle. See, this is Mother Earth. This is Chandra. Chandra is revolving like this. Ding, 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 very quickly. Right? Where are these? You know, nakshatra. Nakshatra pockets are like here. Nakshatra pockets are all around 365. So when your Chandra is here, it is actually taking energy from this pocket. When the Chandra is here, taking from this pocket. From here, it is from this pocket. When Chandra is here, based on the angle, it is taking the energy. Same is happening to all other planets in the zodiac. Like this, if this is a zodiac, there's a planet here, you know, from the Mother Earth, it is at an angle, there must be a nakshatra associated. This is actually how things are running in the universe. Am I clear? Is it clear? Did you actually got the idea that how this universe is working?
Yes, sir.
Any confusion?
Yes. Yes.
There's a confusion?
No.
No confusion, right? Now you've understood how the magic is happening. It is happening through angles and vibrations. Okay, so now you see. So sun is exalted here. Okay. But why Ashwini is associated with Ketu Maharaj? Can you all hear me? Okay, great.
Yes.
There are several mythological or mythological stories behind Ketu association with Ashwini. One is a story where Indra has actually cut the head of Ashwini brothers that are associated. They're actually children of Sun. Okay. And we'll take the story in the presentation. And a horse head was given to the Ashwini brothers. And anything which is headless is always associated with Ketu. So what is another power which was headless? Ganesha. That is why whenever you have Ketu problem, we always tell you, do Ganesh Gayatris. Remember? Whenever you will see something headless, it is representing Ketu. And Ketu was, you know, the Ganesha was given the head of an elephant. So until Ganesha was headless, what was Ganesha? Ketu. And when the elephant head was given, it became Ganesha. You know, the leader of all the Ganas. Who are Ganas? Gana is the security team of Shiva. You know who are, it is like the army of Shiva. They are called Gana. And these Ganas are every single thing. Ganas are every single thing. From Asuras to Tantra, the Mantra, the people who are positive and negative, all sort of energies are actually protecting Shiva. From insects to animals to everyone. And Ganpati is called the king of all the Ganas, chief of the security of the Shiva. Now, Ketu is actually associated for multiple reasons. In Aries, 0 degree to 13 degree 20 minutes is Ashwini. The name Ashwini is because of the Ashwini twin brothers who were born out of Surya. And Ash is also meaning a very quick and fast. And Ashva Medhyag associated with horse. Now, the most important thing is to understand Ketu here. For that, we'll have to understand the formula of rebirth. This is a soul. A soul size is like a size of a thumb. Your soul, my soul, every soul, the size of the soul is like a size of a thumb. Exactly. If you have a bigger thumb, you have a bigger soul. If you have a smaller thumb, you have a smaller soul. If your karmas are good, it will be a bright soul. If your karmas are bad, it will be a dark soul. Simple. जैसे जोत होती है, कभी आपने सोचा जोत का साइज एक अंगूठे जितना क्यों होता है? बिकॉज इट इज रिप्रेजेंटिंग अ सोल, आत्मा, और उसकी शेप भी सोल की जो है वो जोत जैसी होती है, जैसी आप दीपक जलाते हैं, एग्जैक्टली सेम. तभी मैंने यहाँ पे बनाया इसको. अगर मैं दीपक में लगाना चाहूं तो मैं लगा सकता हूं. यू अंडरस्टैंड? तो जब आप जोत जलाते हो तो आप क्या करते हो? आप अपनी आत्मा को शुद्ध करते हो. ओके? आप अपनी आत्मा को भगवान को निछावर करते हो, आत्मा को परम शक्ति में मर्ज करते हो. तो वो क्या बन जाता है? परमात्मा. परमात्मा ये एक सोल है. इसने अभी अभी शरीर छोड़ा है और अब ये डिसाइड होना है कि मोक्ष मिलेगा या दोबारा से शरीर मिलेगा. हर एक सिस्टम को चलाने के लिए कुछ प्रोटोकॉल्स होते हैं. उस प्रोटोकॉल में पहला प्रोटोकॉल ये पूछा जाता है कि व्हाट आर दी पेंडिंग कर्मास. पेंडिंग क्या है भाई साहब? भाई साहब इसने चोरी की थी, अब जिसके घर चोरी की थी उसको वापस लौटाने हैं पैसे. जिसका दिल दुखाया था या तो उससे जाके क्षमा मांगनी है अगले जन्म में, या वो तंग करेगा इसको और वो कार्मिक सेटलमेंट खत्म होगा. विष्णु जी कहते हैं इसको छोड़ दो, जाने दो, इसको मोक्ष दे दो. जितने भी बुरे कर्म हैं, लेट इट गो. आत्मा इतनी डिस्टर्ब्ड होती है, वो कहती है नहीं नहीं मेरी तो बड़ी इच्छाएं हैं, मैं तो अभी अपने बच्चों को बड़ा होते उसके वो आगे से आगे बच्चे देखने थे, मेरी पीछे इतनी बड़ी बड़ी गाड़ियां पड़ी हैं, मेरा इतना बड़ा घर है, मुझे वापस भेजो वहां पे, मुझे करना है जाना है। विष्णु जी एक बार बोलते हैं, कहते ठीक है जाने दो, जब इसको समझ में आ जाएगी तब इसको मोक्ष दे देंगे। ये सोल विष्णु जी की एनर्जी से बाहर आके 9 प्लैनेट्स की एनर्जी में आ जाती है। 9 प्लैनेट्स हैं, चित्रगुप्त हैं, सब बैठे हैं, इस शरीर को नया, इस सोल को नया शरीर देना है, इसके माता पिता बहन भाई ये सब कैलकुलेट करने हैं, कैलकुलेट हो जाते हैं, एल्गोरिथम तैयार हो जाती है, मृत्यु डिसाइड हो जाती है, कितने साल लगेंगे इसको ये सब करने में, यानी कि आपका संचित में से प्रारब्ध निकाल के तैयार कर दिया जाता है। उस प्रारब्ध का थैला इन 9 ग्रहों में से अलग अलग ग्रहों को थ्रू नक्षत्र दे दिया जाता है कि सेटल करो। अब आत्मा से पूछा जाता है कि तुम्हारी डिजायर्स क्या हैं? व्हाट आर योर डिजायर्स? आत्मा कहती है मेरी एक ये डिजायर है, एक ये डिजायर है, एक ये डिजायर है, एक ये डिजायर है। भगवान कहते हैं ये सारी डिजायर्स राहु को दे दो, साथ ही केतु भागा हुआ आता है। केतु बेसिकली एक एनर्जी है, वो कहता है प्रभु जी इसमें से ये वाली 2 डिजायर्स तो इसकी ऑलरेडी फुलफिल हो चुकी हैं, इसको खत्म करो, ये दोबारा क्यों मांग रहा है? जैसे आपने सुबह मेडिसिन ली और आप भूल गए और 11 बजे आप अपने बेटे को बुला के बोलते हो बेटा मेडिसिन देना, बेटा कहता है पापा अभी तो आपने सुबह मेडिसिन ली थी, ओ हाँ सच मैंने ली थी मैं भूल गया। आपने किसी से पेमेंट ली आप भूल गए, बंदा आया कहता भौजी मेरा काम, क्या अब तूने पेमेंट तो की नहीं, कहता भौजी ये देखो रसीद मैंने पेमेंट, ओहो तेरी तो पेमेंट आई हुई है मैं भूल गया आई एम सॉरी, इसको फटाफट से इसका सामान दे दो। केतु आपकी सारी विशेष को डिजायर्स को क्या करता है, क्या करता है फिल्टर करता है। वो कहता है देखो ये सब चीजें आप ऑलरेडी अकम्प्लिश कर चुके हो, लेट इट गो। इसीलिए जहां पर केतु बैठता है आपकी कुंडली में वो एरिया 0 होता है, जो मैंने वीडियो में सिखाया परसों, क्योंकि उस घर उस एरिया उस नक्षत्र के जितनी भी आपकी विशेष थी वो ऑलरेडी आप पूरी कर चुके हो। मेरा केतु 10वें भाव में है, मैं अपना प्रोफेशन जी चुका हूं अपने पिछले जन्मों में, इसीलिए सारा कॉर्पोरेट छोड़ के मैं इस काम में हूं, लेकिन बच्चे हैं खर्चे हैं तो फीस ली जाती है। अदरवाइज सतयुग में अगर मैं टीचर होता तो मेरे बच्चों की स्कूल फीस, मेरा घर, बिजली, गाड़ी, मुझे सब कुछ राजा से फ्री मिलता, सभी ऋषियों का खाना पानी राशन कपड़े दान दक्षिणा टोटली एवरी मंथ इट यूज टू कम फ्रॉम द राजा, सो देन दे आस्क फॉर दक्षिणा, उसके ऊपर वो दक्षिणा लेते थे, लेकिन उनके सारे खर्चे सरकार चलाती थी। आज सरकार नो कमेंट्स, आज की डेट में सिस्टम कलयुग है। सो केतु टेल्स है दिस इज द फिल्ट्रेशन। अब जब आपका प्रॉपर पूरा का पूरा पैकेज बन गया एक साल का कि इतने एक्सीडेंट होने हैं, इतना दुख मिलना है, इतनी तकलीफ मिलनी है, इतनी खुशियां मिलनी है, शनि देव को बता दिया गया कि शनि देव ये आपकी रिस्पॉन्सिबिलिटी है, मेक श्योर ये सारी की सारी चीजें सेटल होनी चाहिए। शनि बेचारा उस हिसाब से उस घर में बैठ जाता है, आप शनि से माफी मांगते हो लेकिन शनि देव को तो विष्णु जी से ऑर्डर है, शनि माफ नहीं करते। और जब शनि की साढ़े सती आती है तो शनि देव, क्योंकि उन्होंने कहा कि साढ़े सती हर एक के जीवन में लाऊंगा, तो उन्होंने कहा कि टेक्निकली मेरे साढ़े सती में हाईएस्ट कार्मिक सेटलमेंट होगा, इसलिए आपको तकलीफ होती है साढ़े सती में। शनि के दो असिस्टेंट हैं, राहु और केतु। राहु दिमाग वाला है तो उसने शनि का एलिमेंट ले लिया विच इज एयर। शनि इज द सोर्स ऑफ द एयर श्वास एंड राहु इज द कैरियर। सो राहु टेक्निकली बिकम्स द कारका ऑफ डेथ ऑल्सो, बिकॉज जब श्वास खत्म तो जो हवा का कैरियर है, जो सांसें चल रही हैं, उसको राहु रोक देगा। अब केतु क्या करे? केतु मृत्यु का नहीं जन्म का कारक बन जाता है, मृत्यु का नहीं जन्म का कारक बन जाता है, मृत्यु का कारक राहु बनता है, क्योंकि राहु केतु के बिल्कुल ऑपोजिट है। ऑब्वियसली अगर राहु मरण का कारक है तो केतु जीवन का कारक है, इसीलिए पहला नक्षत्र अश्विनी जोडियक साइन में किसको दिया गया? केतु। इट्स वेरी 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 डीप, इट्स एक्सट्रीमली डीप। अंटिल यू डोंट अंडरस्टैंड हाउ केतु इज एसोसिएटेड, आई एम नॉट सेइंग केतु इज लॉर्ड ऑफ अश्विनी, नेवर एवर यूज दीज वर्ड्स। Ketu is associated with Ashwini. The energy of Ashwini Nakshatra is the energy of Ashwini brothers who were doctors to the gods. They were physicians to the gods. So people who are born in Ashwini Nakshatra, I have seen so many physicians, doctors from medical professions, healers, which I will explain you in the presentation. But my question is, have you understood the concept of Surya, 365 days, planets, pockets, civilization as an Ashwini, the why Ashwini is the first nakshatra, why Ketu is associated with Ashwini? Now, there is another concept. You say, hey, Ketu will take what element? Right, Ketu will take the elements of where it is starting the life. It is starting the life in a zodiac of Aries, and the lord of Aries is Mars. So automatically from Surya, you know, Surya is the source of fire. Mars is carrying that fire, and then Mars is also giving it to Ketu. That is why the Panch Bhuta, the five element associated with Ketu is fire. It is the fire. And since Ketu is on the top, you know, finalizing Mars's desire, right? And Ketu is filtering your desires by telling that this is already accomplished. That is why Ketu is also called as the higher form of Mars. The filtered desire. The filtered desire. The higher form of Mars. Did you get the point? Did you get the point, ladies and gentlemen? A lot of concepts are now clear. Lot of concepts. Why Ketu was always associated with Mars? Because Mars is desired, Ketu is your filtered desire because Ketu know that you've achieved this in the past. This is not required. Simple. Am I making some sense to you, ladies and gentlemen? Do we have questions here? Was it an eye-opening thing for you today? And after this understanding, Ashwini will be a piece of a cake. Just understanding the gunas, the stories, weaknesses and strengths, and then applying those weaknesses and strengths to the natives. That's it. What is a nakshatra doing? Nakshatra wants to send you energy. He doesn't have a medium. He's taking planets as the medium and sending it to you. It's only that the taste of the planet is also coming with the energy of the nakshatra. That's your life. Simple. And when you see a horoscope with this perspective, what a fantastic astrologer you will become. What a superb, you know, I mean, last week I was giving a consultation to one of my students here in the class. And, you know, I was telling him that, you know, hey, look, your wife was an artist in the childhood. So, oh, Guruji, how do you know that? I mean, we never told you that. Because I was looking at the taste of that planet, which is coming from a particular nakshatra. People think that, oh, Jyotish is a bookish knowledge, you know. Jyotish is far away from the books, you know. I just know the basics from the Shastras. That day, Anuja had, you know, sent a screenshot in the discussion group. Guruji, what is the reference? I don't know what the hell is reference. I don't know that. I have not read all these books. And I have nobody to tell you the reference. Because more and more research you will do, more and more books you will read, you will go haywire. Just read, just follow K.N. Rao. If you want to read, read Sanjay Ratji. You know, K.N. Rao ji, B.V. Raman ji, or the Shastras. And I also like the work of V.P. Goyal. Right? And if you ask me that they have written this line and where is the source, how would I know? Where is the reference? How would I know? You understand? Jyotish is far bigger than the books. Jyotish is the, you know, the connection that you make while you are meditating. That is what Jyotish is. You understand? Jyotish is understanding the energy of a particular planet. You understand? So that is why immediately I had sent 3 or 4 books in the group. That, hey, start from Laghu Parashari. Even if you're not understanding anything, something is going in your subconscious mind. No problem. But when you will understand, you will be able to connect to your subconscious mind. And that fetch that knowledge. You know what I mean? This is what I mean. That Jyotish is something that comes out of the mouth of the guru. That is Jyotish. Jyotish is not a book. When guru says, hey, this is the meaning of this thing. That is what Jyotish is all about. And whenever you are reading such books which are not worth it, it is your bad time. Some bad karma is coming in your, you know, around you because of which you are feeling distracted. If you really want to understand Ashwini, just research about horses. What are the qualities of a horse? Just horses. Forget about nakshatra. Just research about horses. If you want to understand about Ashwini, just research about Ashwini brothers. Just Ashwini brothers. Forget about the nakshatra. And if you have patience, research it for 30 days. How many days? 30 days. And when you research it for 30 days, in a year, you will only do 12 nakshatras. And it will take 2.5 years to master nakshatras. That is a minimum time. Even if I have given you the information of Ashwini, keep on researching with the patience. Make notes, make charts, paste those charts in your room. Keep looking at different birds associated, then research on that bird. There's a tree which is associated with Ashwini. Research on that plant and tree and benefits. You will find all the same traits in a native of Ashwini. This is what I'm trying to tell you. This is called mastering nakshatras. This is called mastering, not understanding a nakshatra. Please do not understand a nakshatra. You can understand a nakshatra within 1 hour. No problem. Read a book, you'll get an idea what is a nakshatra. But to master a nakshatra, it is a sadhana, a continuous sadhana. Researching all the time, all the way. Okay? Am I making some sense, ladies and gentlemen? That is how I have learned Jyotish. Okay, any questions? No questions? Fantastic.